Yeah, obviously, look, injuries are part of the game. We've had injuries before at very crucial times in tournaments and big series as well. Morne Morkel was injured for our last two games. He was possibly our best seamer in a couple of the games. But Ashwin definitely, yeah, he's a world-class bowler. And I think India did miss him a bit. But injuries are part of the game. I mean, that's it's something you can't focus on too much. Yeah, it's incredible achievement by us to win both the series. And I have a feeling, obviously, that the test matches will be a big challenge again. India would want to come back harder and stronger, and we know they have the ability to do that. So once again, we'll be up for it. We're very hungry for success. We're very hungry to create history as a cricket team. We love traveling abroad, and that's where our team spirit kicks in and really plays a role in us playing better cricket. So there's no reason why we can't win the test series, but we know there's a lot of hard work ahead. It's four test matches on some of the harder test wickets in India, and obviously they will be up for it as well. So it's going to be a great test series. Yeah, first of all, I don't think of totals really when I'm batting. I get a sense of if it's a good wicket or not. I've played here before, and I know it's very difficult to defend when guys get going, especially when the partnership's building. I don't really think of totals. I know our strength, and that's to have wickets in hand at the end. So constantly I'm thinking about not going too early. Just one of us must go. I can't leave Faf out there because he looks like he's cramping. So I was a bit of in a 50-50 mindset today. It was really difficult for me to control. I got a sniff early on, got a bit of momentum on my side. I wanted to go, but I held myself back the whole time, thinking of just wait for Faf to get out first, and then I can have a go with some of the new batters. So that's what I try to do. Quinny de Kock, yeah, just very happy for him. He's gone through a tough patch. He did it the right way. He went back to SIA cricket, to domestic cricket, did the hard yards, worked on his technique, scored a lot of runs, and I'm a big fan. You know, I've always been behind him, and I feel he's going to be a great cricket player one day. He's not far off already, but he's young, and you know you shouldn't boost the guy too much when he's young. But the way he's playing at the moment, just with incredible flair and also a great mind while he's playing. So that's something that doesn't come around very often at that age, and I'm proud of what he's achieved. I thought it was going to spin a bit more. It wasn't not turning, it was a little bit of turn, but it was a good cricket wicket. I think it played very similar in both innings. I thought it came on really nicely in the evening as well. But obviously at the end of the day, we had too many runs and played really well with a bat in hand, and gave the bowlers a lot of freedom to follow their game plans with a lot of aggression and pace, which they did. I'm not too surprised, no. I've played in Mumbai a lot of times in the past, and it's always been a really good cricket wicket. It reminds me a lot of Wanderers back home in Johannesburg. So I think it was just a very fair contest today between bat and ball. Yeah, he's another one that's knocking on the door of greatness in the future. He knows he's got hard work ahead and a lot of battles to go through, a lot of form changes, up and downs and all of that. But look, there's a lot of talent there. There's also a great mind on his shoulders and easy to work with. It's an absolute pleasure to be a captain to a guy like that who knows what he wants. Pretty clear with his decision making, and he wants to be there. You can see he's hungry and he wants to succeed and win games for South Africa. And so that's exactly what you want as a captain, and the kind of guy that you want in a team. So looking forward to see him grow into a great bowler one day.